Sweet insomniacs, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys for joining me today. I'm very excited about this because 2 weeks ago I announced my first Q&A and I received a ton of questions from you. I'm gonna try to answer as many of them as I can. And I'm gonna do it in a whispered way, from ear to ear, of course, to relax you. Also, this will be accompanied by some relaxing trigger sounds for all of you who are not that interested in what I'm gonna say. So I do some tapping. Scratching, and a few other trigger sounds. So, without further ado, let's begin. I'm gonna start with a few very basic questions. First question, how old are you? I turned 29 recently. I was born in 1988 and my star sign is Pisces, if you're interested in that. I considered myself a typical Pisces when I used to believe in that as a teenager. But I don't do anymore. A second question. How tall are you? My height is 186 centimeter, which is about 6'1" in American measurements. So, pretty average for a guy, I would say. Necessarily true for Germany, but it certainly is for Bavaria. So, if you ever want to experience traditional Germany, I highly recommend you traveling to Bavaria. It also has some beautiful landscapes and architecture. Here comes a simple question. Are you left-handed or right-handed? I'm right-handed, just as easy as that. What's your favorite color? Black, which isn't a color, as you know, but it's the absence of color, to be precise. Although, I have to say, there's a different color for every face in life, but mostly black. Where did you get that cool logo and the hat? Will you release merch? How can we get that hat? I was surprised that so many of you were asking for the hat. That's the perfect opportunity to announce that you can have it from now on. So, this is my new merchandise shop, and as you can see, you can have it as a classic baseball cap or as a flex fit baseball cap in black or white in your own size of Besides that, you can have some other cool clothing items that I've designed with the Zeitgeist brand. This is the basic collection, and I'm going to add new clothing items on a regular basis. So please, visit my shop. You'll find the link in the description down below. How did you come up with your logo? I wanted to have a symbol that represents Zeitgeist, or the spirit of time, so to speak. And I was thinking about that, and one day I was walking down the street and I saw this in a shop window, and I thought to myself, well, that's it, that's your logo. And I bought it, I went home, and I did my first initial sketch here in my moleskin notebook, where I write down my ideas. Yeah. Here comes the most popular question. This has been asked in variations many times, and basically it's about my story. You asked, how did you get into ASMR? What's the first ASMR video you have ever watched? And what or who inspired you to start an ASMR channel? So, I came across an online article a few years ago. It was about ASMR, of course. And I guess it was in 2013. I can't remember the exact date, but 2013. I read the article, and I knew I would love it before I even watched a single video. That was because the article described a feeling that I've experienced all my life, but I didn't know there was an expression for it. Well, there was a link in the article that led to a video from Gentle Whispering. And the video was, oh, such a good 3D sound. I guess that's the right title, but I can't say for sure. And I watched it, and I was hooked from the first moment. So I binge watched a lot of videos from many different artists that day, and I got major tingles, and I was thrilled and amazed, because I thought, can it really be that easy to relax, to be in the moment? It felt like being high on a drug without side effects, which is amazing, of course. The same evening, I got a call from a very good friend of mine, and she said, I have to tell you about this new thing. It's called ASMR, and I know you'll like it. And I was like, what? I already know. And that was quite a coincidence, I guess, because it was even less popular back then. So we talked about it for a while, and I don't remember who, but one of us came up with the idea to make a channel together, just for fun. So my friend lost interest after a while, but I kept on developing the idea in my head, and but I sadly never had the time to realize it, because I had a very stressful and demanding job back then. 3 years later, I lost my job due to unlucky circumstances, and I took the opportunity to finally realize my channel. And here we are. You also wanted to know my first ASMR experience and who or what triggered it. story that I share with a lot of people, I would say, because I was at the hair salon as a child. I can't remember exactly how old I was, very little. I was there with my brother and my mom, and I can't remember any further detail, who cut my hair or where I sat. But I'm able to recall the feeling to this day. The blow dryer somewhere in the background, and the cool gentle hands on my head. The sounds of the scissors close to my ears. And so on. I got major tingles. And still to this day, for me, the hair salon is the place to go to get some nice real-life tingles. I really enjoy going to the hairdresser. Next question. Do you like ASMR in other languages, and if so, which ones and which ASMR artists? Mostly I enjoy listening to ASMR in English. I don't really listen to ASMR in my own language because it would feel too real somehow. But listening in English helps me to dive into this fantasy world. I like to understand what people are saying though, but there are moments when I watch it in other languages, and if that's the case, I like the sound of French and Spanish. And the artists to go are Paris ASMR, Made in France ASMR, Whisper Latina, DeLuca, and Hermetic Kitten. Next question. You wanted to know, how long does it take you to make and edit a video? And is there a certain creative process or routine? Yes, there is, and it takes a while. All in all, it takes about 30 hours at least, I would say. After some idea pops up, I start writing a little script that I write down in my notebook. I just write down what it's about, how it's gonna be structured, and roughly what I wanna say. Depending on which type of video I wanna do, I have to provide some props or see what I can find around the house. Normally, in the evening, I set up the camera, my microphone, the lighting, and the backdrop, and then I make a few camera tests to see if everything looks alright. When I'm pleased with that, I get myself ready and drink a huge can of Red Bull, and then I have to wait till 2 o'clock in the morning at least, because my apartment isn't soundproof, and I have to wait till it's dead silent and the neighbors are quiet. Then I film, and normally it's 6 or 7 o'clock in the morning when I'm finished. Then I'm pretty exhausted and I take a nap for 2 to 3 hours, and after that I get up and start editing. The way I edit my videos is kind of elaborate, I would say, and it takes at least 8 hours. And after that, I have to make a thumbnail, video description, social media posts, all that stuff. And when I'm lucky and everything went well, I'm ready to post the video the same evening. So, as you can see, it's it's quite stressful and I'm literally working all around the clock. But I really enjoy doing it. I like the process. It begins with an idea on paper and it ends up with your comments, which is normally really rewarding. Next question. Who are your favorite ASMR YouTuber? I have to say, Gentle Whispering is my most favorite. She's my all-time relaxation guru. I know that's kind of boring because she's the most popular out there. But honestly, I don't know how she does it. I relax within seconds when I listen to her. It's magical. I almost listen to her every night. I also really love Whispers Red, almost equally to Gentle Whispering. The way she talks and acts is so soothing and comforting, and it comes across so kind and genuine. But there are a lot of other artists that I enjoy listening to, like DeLuca, for instance, Adra ASMR, ASMR Magic, she's great, Paris ASMR, Minx Laura, of course, Ricky Seven Whispers, Roscoe Ball Rabbit, Night Shift ASMR, Articulate Design, just to name a few. And many, many more. And oh, Dirar Adeyuelo, if I said the name wrong, I'm sorry. What's the best ASMR video you've ever seen? The one you always go back to. One video I always go back to, and that I never watched entirely because I always fell asleep before it ended, is Face Mapping for Your Napping from, again, Gentle Whispering. Only thinking about it makes me drowsy. For me, a very powerful video. I put the link down in the description. And a video that I also watched very often is from Whispers Red, and it's called Slurpy Clicks, Crinkles, and Tinks for Tingles. In this video, she got various strange objects that two artists send her. And it's an amazing video because she makes very experimental, unusual sounds with that. But it's very relaxing. Again, the link is down in the description. Listen to your own videos to relax. Do you give yourself ASMR? No, I don't, because, as I mentioned earlier, it can take up to 8 hours to edit my videos, and I have to stay quite concentrated throughout the whole process. And of course, it's very boring sometimes, and I really have to fight against getting sleepy. And after that, I have enough of watching myself, I can assure you. But sometimes, a few weeks later, when I rewatch that video, I sometimes think, oh, that's really good, actually, you did a good job. I listen to others to relax, though. Which one of your own videos is your favorite? I can't think of a particular one at the moment. There are a few that turned out quite good, I think. I really like Tingles Out of the Blue. You drift down deeper. ASMR in the rain. Don't you love it when it rains? And ASMR by the fire. So tingly. So relaxing. To these videos down in the description. Next question was also quite popular. What's your favorite trigger to listen to and to make for others? What's your ultimate never fail ASMR trigger that always relaxes / tingles you? My favorite trigger to listen to is simply whispering. I don't care if it's a female or a male voice, as long it is clear and has a warm tone. I just don't like it when it sounds strained in some way, and I don't like too high and girly voices as well. And my favorite trigger to perform is definitely tapping. When I do tapping videos, I have these moments when I truly get into some kind of trance, and it really relaxes me. I developed this annoying habit to tap on almost everything in my daily life. I got funny glances in public occasionally since I developed this habit, but I don't care. Which is a common trigger that you not like. I absolutely hated mouth sounds for a long time. I found it okay when it came naturally, but I never watched videos when it was done on purpose. But surprisingly, that has changed over time, and I figured that it can be very powerful for me when it's done by the right artist. When will you have Patreon? Good news for everyone who feels the need to support me. I'm setting up my Patreon account these days, and I hope it's ready to launch by the time I post this video. You'll find the link in the description, so please consider supporting this channel. As a patron, you get exclusive rewards like merchandise, personalized drawings, and your own custom videos. Check it out. What was it like growing up in Germany? I guess it was good. It's a rather wealthy country with a good education system, and we lived in a rural corner when I was a child, and as I said, as a Bavarian, I experienced the full German cliché, which wasn't bad at all. Sometimes I found my environment a bit narrow-minded, especially as a teenager, because I always wanted to be an artist, and I had the feeling that irritated some people. I moved to a big city later on, and that was good for my personal growth. But yeah, growing up in Germany was good. What were you like in high school? That's an interesting question. We have another school system here. I was wasn't in a high school. I was on three different schools, and each had its emphasis on different subjects. I guess my role and my popularity was very diverse throughout my school years. There were times when I was quite popular and had a lot of friends, and there were times when I was a complete outsider. But in general, I was rather shy, I would say, and I always sat in the last row, doodling on my notepad and paying no attention to the lessons. Teachers didn't like me. The next question is from my lovely friend Euridia, and she wanted to know, what advice would you give to your younger self? I guess my younger self wouldn't take any advice from me, because I remember that I took it from nobody. And I guess that's how it should be, because you have to learn it all by yourself, right? Besides that, if I gave my younger self an advice, wouldn't that imply that I regret something? And I honestly regret nothing. It's okay how it all turned out. And what we learned from Back to the Future is, don't mess with the time-space continuum. Next question. Besides creating ASMR, what's your number one passion, your favorite thing to do, hobbies outside of YouTube, basically? Well, making ASMR doesn't leave much room for many other hobbies at the moment, I have to admit. But I am, and always was, a great movie nerd, and I'm one of those people who buy the over-expensive special edition of a certain movie and that watch all the background materials and even the audio commentary. I remember my old room was plastered with movie posters from cult classics. I like movies from every period and from all around the world. I'm not able to point out a favorite movie because there are so many that I love. Movies, that's my thing. I also like art and photography, and I like to draw, obviously. Also, I do some sports about 3 times a week. What I'm currently doing is called freeletics, and it's some sort of CrossFit. It's really hard. And besides that, I practice yoga since I'm 15 or something. Yes, that's it, I would say. A lot of you wanted to know, what do you do for a living? What have you studied? Do you have an art degree / job? I studied communication design or visual communication, which is another term for graphic design, more or less. I used to work as an art director at different companies and agencies, and so yes, you can say I have an art-related job. As I mentioned before, I lost my job due to unlucky circumstances, which gave me the opportunity to make ASMR. Besides that, I'm working as a freelancer at the moment. I have to go back to a regular job though, and I really hope and pray that I have the time, that I find the time to keep on making videos. Is there something you wish you could do if money was not a factor? At the moment, I'd love to keep on doing ASMR. Do you have a video production background? Although I'm a designer, I have no video production background. I had to learn that all from the scratch when I started making videos. It may became a bit easier to me because I was familiar with other design software. Next question. You are very good at drawing. How long have you been drawing? And when did you start drawing? I always wanted to be an animation artist at Disney when I was little. So I used to watch the Disney classics on VHS, and I was obsessed. I watched them over and over again. My childhood was a Disney marathon, and I always drew the characters whilst watching. You can say I studied those videos more or less. So, next question. This has been asked quite a few times. Why do you always wear a cap? We want to see you without it, please. Well, I really love my cap. It's my trademark. And I almost always wear caps in daily life as well. And I like to keep things mysterious. But here's a little insider tip. If you want to see me without it, follow me on Instagram. What's your favorite food? Fast food, I have to admit. If I could, I would eat burger and french fries every day. And there are times when I do that, admittedly. But I have to stop that after a while because I tend to get chubby really fast. How many languages do you speak? Only German and English. I tried to learn French a few years ago, but I failed really hard because I lost track. I still love to learn it though, but currently I'm really interested in learning Dutch because it's just a dream at the moment, but I see myself living in Amsterdam in the future. That would be freaking awesome. What's your favorite animal? Do you have pets? No, I don't have pets. And but I'm a total cat person though. Sadly, I don't have one. I live downtown right now, and I don't think it's the right environment for a cat. Next question, are you a daddy? Well, in the sense of being an actual dad, no. And I intend to keep it that way, to be honest, because if I don't want to be responsible for a cat, how can I be responsible for a child? I like children though. I have a little nephew that I adore, but thank God it's not my son. Dick Balls wanted to know, are you my dad? I am your dad. If it makes you happy. And to everyone who calls me daddy, I don't mind at all. You seem to have collective daddy issues though, but I'm here for you. Has anybody recognized you in public? That luckily never happened, and honestly, it'll probably just wondering. Rob, my good friend, I already gave you an answer to that, but I repeat it for everyone who liked that significant question. 7.5. Rob also wanted to know, do you collect anything? Coins, stamps, antiques, cars? The only thing I kind of collect is caps. I have a lot and I stopped counting at some point. I can't really say that I collect them though, because I just want to have them and wear them. And when they're worn out, I throw them away. So, I guess I don't collect anything. Sorry. This is an interesting question. What age was your first kiss? You mean my first French kiss, I suppose. I was 14, and I sat in the bus with my classmates, and we were on our way back home from a school trip, and we started playing Truth or Dare, and so it happens that I got my first kiss from a girl named Claudia, and it totally grossed me out. But we repeated it again and again. We practiced that day, and after that she became my girlfriend for a while. But it didn't last that long. Do you play video games, and if so, do you prefer Nintendo, Sony, or Xbox? I do play video games, and I see myself as a casual gamer. I don't play that much as I used to. I'm a total Nintendo fanboy. And I always was, since I got my first Game Boy. I played on other consoles and on PC, but I always loved Nintendo the most. That's because I really love the world they created, and the Zelda series is my most favorite out of that. Do you remember your dreams, and if so, what is the best dream you ever had? I do remember my dreams sometimes, but I can't remember the best dream I've ever had. And maybe it would be inappropriate to talk about it on YouTube, because as you know, dreams are seldom censored. I tried practicing lucid dreaming for a while, which really seemed to work. The downside is you have to sleep a lot and you have to follow a certain routine, which I couldn't incorporate into my daily life on the long run. I'm still very interested though. When are you going to release your notes? I don't know yet, to be honest. Follow me on Instagram. What's your most favorite European city? My favorite European city is certainly Amsterdam. I travel there every spring to celebrate my birthday, and it became a holy tradition over the years. It's a beautiful, cozy city with wonderful architecture, and it feels like a small town, but with all the advantages of a large city. It has a high quality of living. What's your opinion on the sexualization of ASMR and ASMR artists? Does it make you uncomfortable? Almost everything is sexualized these days. You can't do anything about it. It's just within the human nature, I guess. And intimacy is an important element of ASMR, and it's a personal attention and seductive behavior, so it's misunderstood by many people. But really, I don't care at all, and I wish you all a happy and fulfilled sex life. So, this question is in German. Kannst du mal ein deutsches ASMR-Video machen und hochladen? Hey, kennst du mein Video 1000 Trigger aus dem Nichts? Das ist komplett in Deutsch. Und in vielen anderen Videos streue ich immer mal ein paar deutsche Sätze ein. Aber ich werde sicher bald mal wieder ein komplett deutsches Video posten. Was wollt ihr sehen? Lass es mich in den Kommentaren wissen. Next question is winter or summer? Definitely winter, but only with a lot of frost and snow, preferably in the woods. Lady Gaga or Katy Perry? Lady Gaga, of course. Which city or states in the US would you like to visit, if any? I'd love to visit the United States someday. I've never been there, and I guess I had to start with the state New York and the city New York, and California, LA. I guess most of all, I want to see LA because I have a very romantic perception on Hollywood. I'm sure it's not like that, though. And there are many other cities that I love to see, like San Francisco, Las Vegas, Dallas, and many, many more. Yeah, if only I had the time and money. Do you have a favorite painting? Which one and why? I honestly was thinking about that for a while, and I think it has to be Edward Hopper's Nighthawks, because it's like a snapshot from a distinct period of time, but simultaneously it's timeless with its message about loneliness and isolation. It's rather melancholy in a very glamorous way. Another painting that crossed my mind is from Caspar David Friedrich, Der Wanderer über dem Nebelmeer, The Wanderer Above the Sea of Fog. It's a beautiful painting, and it's a metaphor for the unknown future. We can't see what lies ahead of us. It's all in the mist. Do you believe in the paranormal? No, I don't. I can't say that for sure, of course, but I never experienced something like that, and there was never ever an evidence that I saw with my own eyes. So, no, I don't. What advice would you have to someone who wants to begin producing ASMR videos? Don't do it for money, don't do it for fame, because both is really hard to achieve with ASMR. Only do it if you really love it, because you have to put a lot of time and effort into that. That's my only advice. And oh, you should take vitamin D because you won't see the daylight anymore. What's your favorite clothing item? At the moment, it's this leather jacket. You saw it in a couple of my videos. It's nothing special though. It's not even real leather. I got it from H&M and it's fairly cheap. personality, or a cat with a dog's personality. If I had to choose, I'd rather have a cat with a dog's personality, because cats are simply cuter, at least from my point of view. And on top of that, it would have the rather friendly and social personality of a dog. But as boring as it is, at the end of the day, I'd prefer a cat with a cat's personality. Something. Huh? What should that be? Well, quite a few people wanted to know about our sexual orientation and if we have a significant other. Ah, right. I remember. So, what's your answer? Oh, well, I'm straight. Yeah, me too. No, you're not. You're totally gay. What? You're gay. Ah, come on. It's okay. Ah, shut up. Let's move on. I don't have a significant other. What about you? Yes, I am with someone for 2 months now.